Hi, Roland from Dare to be Different here. This is an unboxing video for the new M-Chuck box. I redesigned the full M-Box based on our S-Chuck box. The old M-Chuck box had a negative thing in the design, which was that if you pull out the drawers, you could not always access the complete inventory. I changed that completely. Let's check it out. What you need is only a knife. Cut carefully the tape. Here. There is in the middle a handle. Just fold it upwards and grab the handle through the fabric of the cover. I will slide the box now from the table to easily lift the chuck box out of the carton box. Let's move the carton box to the side. Remove the fabric cover. It's very simple now and the principle stays the same as for the old M-Chuck box and the S-Chuck box. Unlock now the four latches. Lift the cover now from the box. You can see that all is packed and wrapped in plastic. There is an inventory list added in this package. I will now start removing the main plastic. The second layer of plastic is underneath the side tables. You have to lift the tables to remove this layer. Let's check the first drawer. What's in this drawer? Two burners, an Ypsilon gas hose and the pots and pans. To remove the pots and pans, you have to remove the tie wrap. It's on this side. Be careful. Cut the tie wrap with a knife or a scissor. Turn the pots and pans now clockwise and lift them from the drawer. Again, the pots and pans are packed in plastic. Here are the pots. This is the frying pan. Here is the heat resistant coaster. What do we have here? One big soup pot lid. One smaller soup pot lid. Two soup or dessert cups. And another two cups. A kettle. The 24 cm soup pot is full stainless steel and has serious safe foldable handles. The bigger soup pot is only 2 cm wider, but further in the same design as the small pot. The bottoms of the pots are in the same design as your pots at home. This is the frying pan, the handle I will show you later. This frying pan is really nice and sturdy. Now we will unpack the kettle. It's 1.4 liters and it is in a bag. In the kettle there is also a tea holder for fresh tea. Now we will start with unpacking the burners. Cut this tie wrap. How do you use the burners? First I will have to make some space. This is what you need to do to place the burner. You can choose to use one or two burners. Lift the first part of the table out. This part is also the windscreen. Unfold it like this and place it on the table. Each burner has its own position. Now take one out. Always place the burner with the regulator to the front. This one goes in the left position, like this. The other one goes in the right position, like that. We now grab the gas hose. The hose is connected to the burner at the bottom of the burner. This hose is an Ypsilon hose. One part of the gas hose is a bit shorter than the other, so you can choose at which side you will place the gas container. To connect the hose, lift the burner and connect the hose. Please connect the hose firmly. There is a shutter valve at the end of each hose. This makes it possible to only connect one burner with the hose to a gas container without escaping gas. The big advantage is that you now can use only one burner with the gas hose and you are not obligated to connect the burner directly on the gas container. Now I will connect the other hose to the other burners. Lift the hose and slightly close the drawer. Place the burner in position and guide the gas hose like this. Adjusting the burners is as follows. At the right you have a little bit more space for adjusting than at the other side. This one is a bit tighter to adjust, but you could always open the drawer a little. The burners are equipped with piezo igniters. The burners are also equipped with wires, so pots have even more support. The pans are very stable on the burners due to these extenders. The other side works exactly the same, of course, and the burners are so far apart that large pans can also be placed side by side. The windscreen is easy to adjust in position. This was all about the first drawer. Two more to go. I will remove the burners, then we have more space to show you all items in drawer 2. I will quickly disconnect the gas hose. This is 1. This is 2. Now just roll up the gas hose and store it in the drawer. Now store the burners back in the drawer. This is 1. This is 2. Now close the drawer. Fold the windscreen and place it back in position on top of the box. Done! Next drawer. This drawer contains the plates. In the new M-Box there are not only 4 plates, but 4 dinner plates and 4 lunch plates. Here is the foldable water basin. I think it's pretty commonly known how this unfolds. Then we have the cups. There are 4 of them. Then we have 2 seasoning pots. I will put all items on top. Then there is a better overview what's in this drawer. 4 cups. The 8 plates. The 2 seasoning pots. That was drawer 2. Now the 3rd drawer. On top there is the cutting board. Here is the kitchen knife with protected cover. Here is the spatula. This is the Dutch cheese slicer. Soup ladle and colander. Here is the food clip. Scissor. Be careful. Here is the fruit knife. It's very sharp. That's also the case for the kitchen knife. Here are the knives of the cutlery. These are the forks. These are the teaspoons. Last of the cutlery are the spoons. Here's the handle for the frying pan. The handle is very easy to attach to the frying pan. Last but not least, the peeler. Quick resume of drawer 3. 4 knives, 4 forks, 4 teaspoons, 4 spoons, peeler, spatula, scissor, fruit knife, food clip, cheese slicer, soup ladle and colander. You can see there is plenty of room for extra items. As a cover is the cutting board used. A simple and effective solution. So closing this drawer. All drawers are pushed to be locked. You have to really pull the drawer firmly to get it unlocked. As you can see, I use my thumb to push to the frame or the drawer above to open it. It's then very easy to open. The new M-Chop box is now also to use without the cover, so now you can place the top of the box independent on a table in the back of your car or you name it. With the old M-Chop box, you always needed this cover to place the chop. The old chop box was otherwise not stable. The new M-Chop box can be placed on top of its cover. I will demonstrate that, but then I will be first placing all pots and pans back into the drawer. First place the insulated pot in the smallest pot. Put the kettle inside. Then the cups. Then put the lid on the smallest pot. Take the lid off the big pot, place the small pot in the big pot and replace the lid. Detach the handle of the frying pan and store it away in the lowest drawer. Open the top drawer. Place the set pots and pans in the drawer. Turn the frying pan counterclockwise until it touches the side of the drawer. I will now place the box on top of its cover. I will fold the side tables. Again, I have to make some space. Then place the box on its cover. The feet of the box fit exactly in the top of the cover. Now we will unfold all tables. In this case, the table is at a height 68 centimeters from the ground. Now we can enlarge the table surface. These parts are really easy to connect to the table. Just hook them on the back table and then place them on the side table. I will disassemble directly because I will show you more details when the chuck box is not on top of its cover. I will lower the top box so I can show you it. Let's place it like this. In the lower position you can also extend the table easy and also partly. Again, all drawers are still accessible also in this situation. Extension parts of the table are very stable. You can also place some load on it. Load on the table is no problem, but the hinges have to be in this lock position. Again, it's very easy to place the table extensions like this in the table. And then there is this huge table. And now, if I place the windscreen and put the burners in place, with the pots in place on the burners, there is still a lot of workspace available. I will now explain how to store the table extension parts. Open the lower drawer. I will turn the box now so it's better on camera. Okay, there are more options to store, but I will demonstrate two ways. The right part of the right extender goes in with the top side up like this. The left extender part of the table slide upside down into the position like this. Now again, but then a closer look. It's also possible to place the left one with the top side up like this and then the right side upside down like this. Close the drawer. To stow away the box, we fold down the side tables. Place now the cover over the box. Lock the four latches. And this is it. So far the unboxing film of the new Amp Chuck Box. If you want to see or test it, contact your local dealer and he or she will tell you what the possibilities are. Thank you for watching this video.